This is my Tesla Model Y. It's now 15 months old, and I've just discovered that these have actually got an internal radar fitted in the headliner here, which Tesla are shortly going to activate with an over-the-air update. So Tesla released this information recently when they were talking about the new redesigned Model Y, the Juniper model. And on those, they were talking about what they're calling a 4D scanner up here in the headlining, which is going to do some very clever things when it comes to detecting occupants inside the car. And they said in the new Model Y, the 4D cabin radar will detect rear passengers and even monitor heart rate and breathing, and will do some very clever things if a child or pet is left in the vehicle. And they can notify the owner on the app, vent the windows, turn on the climate, or even call the emergency services if needed. This will all be activated in an over-the-air update in Q3 of 2025. But what I've discovered is this radar unit, which is fitted in the headliner here, has been fitted in the Model Ys since about November 2021, and also in the Model 3 Highland, and I assume in the previous generation Model 3 from about the same age as well. So coming soon to existing Tesla owners will be another free over-the-air update, and that will be version 2025.2.6, and that will be enabling this overhead cabin radar unit, which has been sat dormant in these cars for a number of years. And today it is the 14th of February 2025. I'm still on version 2024.45.32.2, but apparently this new software update will be rolling out soon. That will be enabling this cabin radar unit, and that will just be for front passenger detection only. So what the update is going to do is detect when there's people sitting in the front seats, but of course that's already done because there's pressure sensors in the seats. But it's going to not only detect when there's people sitting in the seats, but it's also going to size them up using the radar. So it's going to measure the size and potentially the weight of the passenger. And then if you're involved in an accident and the airbags deploy, it's going to adjust those airbags to suit the type of passenger sitting in the seat. So it's all about improving safety and improving the way the airbags deploy. Later in the year, they're obviously updating the software again, and this cabin radar will be used to detect passengers in the rear seats. But what I'm not sure yet is whether the radar fitted in the existing cars is going to be able to detect rear passengers in the same way as it can detect front passengers, or whether that's something that's just reserved for the later cars. But either way, it's just great that Tesla vehicles just keep getting better with these free over-the-air updates. And new features are added using hardware that was already fitted in the car when new, even though the customer didn't pay any extra for it. Just like the adaptive matrix headlights, which was enabled on UK vehicles in March 2024. And I see that over in the States, American drivers are going to have theirs enabled shortly too. It could be that delays in enabling the existing hardware fitted in the factory on these cars, such as the adaptive headlights or the cabin radar, are due to regulations or approvals rather than Tesla being late in writing the actual software. So it's great that the safety on this car, and of course all other Teslas on the road, are improving, and that's without it going into the garage, without any new hardware being fitted, and of course without spending any money. And I assume this car does indeed have a radar fitted up here, but time will tell. I'll see if I get this new software update. So if you're thinking about buying a Tesla, my referral link is below, and that gets you money off your new order. And if you want to know more about the Model Y, also below is a link to a playlist where you can see other videos I've made on these vehicles. So that'll do for this one. If you found it useful or interesting, as always, please do click the thumbs up. That really does help. Also comment below, and I'll see you on the next one.